Anyway, the president is expected to call for more money for things like dams when he unveils his jobs plan, we're told, as Democrats clamor for a lot more what they call infrastructure spending.
Next week, I'll be speaking to the nation about a plan to create jobs.
It should not take another collapsing bridge or failing levee to shock us into action.
Our roads and bridges are deteriorating.
So does any of this ring a toll bell? Well, it should, because that's what tolls were supposed to pay for. And at least a half a dozen prior federal construction projects were supposed to pay for. And countless state fees and surcharges over decades were supposed to pay for. And Kate Obenshain of the Young Americas Foundation says still no paint for the bridge to nowhere. You know, I never fault their good intentions. But we need a construction size a lockbox here, and we never get it because this money always goes to other purposes and not the one intended.
Including the gas tax, Neil.
Sure.
You know, over 35% of the funds that are in the federal trust fund for transportation are diverted to parks and historic preservation, mass transit, bike trails, instead of going to these fundamental programs. You know, if more money were the answer, then we would have the safest roads, the safest bridges in our nation's history, because we've actually increased funding for transportation. I believe it's 7 times the rate of inflation over the since the year 2000.
All right, but now you have a case where we're showing some bridges and roads that were really badly banged up by Irene, and some of them were in bad shape to begin with, so this sort of pushed them over the edge. So the president will have something to argue for more such a building to get them repaired. My only worry is, even if you argue for the billions that could be potentially proposed, you have to find a way to make sure that it's going to fix those bridges, and a lot of times it doesn't.
Well, of course it doesn't. And you look at the president's priorities right now, that is the essence of the problem, Neil. Instead of going to the government's responsibility of making sure that our roads and our bridges are safe, instead we've got the president proposing $53 billion for this fast rail with no cost analysis benefit. This is government's philosophy. Instead of focusing on the true, real, good purposes of government and of our responsibility to provide for just this kind of scenario, we're off helping build more bike trails with federal funds when we've seen unsustainable increases in transportation spending right now. We've just seen we've just hit the $4 trillion mark that the president has increased the debt by, and yet we're talking about adding to that. How about focusing our transportation funds on what is real and necessary, and right now, frankly, cutting out the stuff that we can put off until we've renewed the prosperity that the free market can bring about. But if we continue to think that just by pouring more and more government money into the problem, this is going to solve the issue, we're making
a
huge mistake.
It is a mess. We focus on bullet trains. How about something safe for them to travel
over? Absolutely.
All right, Kate, well said. Kate is